How should one prepare for geometry? And this is a topic, this is a question that I keep getting from people. The offshoot of that question is, I don't get geometry, can I dump this? Right? You should prepare for geometry from first principles. So learn triangles. Learn that sum of two sides of a triangle has to be greater than the third one. The sum of three angles of a triangle is equal to 180 degrees. Then learn circles, then quadrilaterals, then polygons. All of geometry started off with some 5-6 ideas. Fine, from Euclid, from elements. And then everything was built on top of that incrementally, slowly, rigorously, with each idea being proved by only using what has gone by before that. The entire idea of proving and establishing is clearly demonstrated and clearly seen throughout geometry. So don't bypass that. Right? So learn geometry iteratively. Learn theorems, learn the theory, do a few questions, and then do a few questions not directly linked to whatever theory you've learned, so that your mind now starts processing, okay, now I'm given a question, which part of the theory will I use? And so knowing that you've just learned congruence and doing three questions in congruence is very easy. Being thrown a question and having to think, okay, do I have to think about congruence or similarity or some other theorem for this question? That's tricky. That iteration is where many people fall off when doing geometry. They learn a chunk, do a bunch of questions. Learn a chunk, do a bunch of questions. It seems easy. It seems very doable. So I'm learning a theory, a bunch of ideas, and I'm applying them. That's easy. And then the most common question is, I see theory, I solve questions, I understand everything. And then I see 15 more questions, and I don't know what to do, what theorem to apply, what formula to plug in for 10 of those questions. That will happen. Which is why geometry is learnt iteratively. You learn theorem, you plug it in, you know that. Then you see questions and then you have your backs handed to you because you're not able to solve it. Go through the solutions. Now you tell your mind, okay, so if this kind of context comes, I need to think about congruence. If this kind of context comes, I need to understand that these three properties in circles are important. One of those I'll have to plug in. That you plug in your second iteration and then revisit that. And should you skip geometry? Most definitely not. And so geometry sets the base for obviously geometry, trigonometry, mensuration, coordinate geometry. So even standalone geometry can account for 7 out of 34 questions. If you add all this, that's 10 out of 34. You can still crack the remaining 24 and get 99.xx percentile, but the pressure just shoots up. If you're leaving one giant called geometry outside, then that means you will chase after that really irritating long-winded speed time question, because you know that you cannot afford to dump that question because you've already set aside 6 to dump for geometry. So not only do you miss out on one chunk, your decision making becomes poorer and poorer. You've already told yourself that you won't touch geometry, and that's a big, big, big gap. Fine. It can be filled. It is easy to do. It is a lot of fun to learn, and it is definitely learnt iteratively. Learn the theory, do a bunch of questions, and then try new questions, relearn the theory. It is done with that circle twice or thrice over. So sign up for that. If you're saying, look, I'm going to have a go at geometry, you're signing up for those three iterations, not learning a formula and then saying, look, anything in geometry, hit me with that. So remember that it can be done, but you have to do it over 2-3 circles. Even if you take 2-3 iterations, it's not going to take forever. It's a very doable topic, and it's a lot of fun to do geometry. So don't start with geometry as a bugbear topic. Put a smile on your face and say, geometry, here I come. It is definitely crackable. Try that. Best wishes for the exam.